band's debut singing, so how about a hand for that? I hear a lot of great soloists on that. David Ellis on the guitar to start things off. The incomparable Vince Norman on tenor saxophone. The award-winning Evan Drum on trombone. Our dueling alto saxophones, Logan Gorrell and Colin Farrell. And of course, the guy driving the bus, Jimmy Chen on drums. So we wanted to play one tune tonight to open the concert that we played at the Monterey Next Generation Jazz Festival a few weeks ago. I'm sure most of you have heard a little bit about it, but just to get invited from the original taped audition to be one of the six college bands to attend the festival, that was a huge honor. And then so we went there and these guys played their hearts out and it was a magical night. And I'm happy to say that they were one of the two bands that tied and we won. We're very excited. In September, we'll be going back to Monterey to play on the main stage at the Monterey Jazz Festival this fall. So that's a huge thing. So yeah, hand for all of these guys. We tied in first place with the University of Denver Lamont Jazz Orchestra that's led by the great Steve Weiss. Fabulous program. And then really separated by one point was the University of Miami, the Frost Concert Jazz Orchestra, which is kind of like their number two band there, which is just a fabulous band. And all of the six bands there were amazing. And so again, just to be a part of that company was a huge honor for us. We really don't see music as a competition. You know, the art form is about the music and that's the thing. But it's nice to be able to talk to some folks that maybe don't understand the music and say, well, as I told a student group this afternoon, that I was talking to, if this was football, it would sort of be like winning Division I national championships. So, you know, that helped them to understand that. So we'll take that. Enough of that stuff. So we're going to play one more tune before we bring Mr. Daversa back up. This next one is written by a good friend and an incredible musician named Donnie McCaslin. This one is called Fast Brazil. In winning the Heisman Trophy, yeah, except they gave out four Heisman Trophies, but they did at the festival, through all the six college bands, they gave out four Outstanding Soloist Awards, and Evan Drum was one of those four awards. Thank you. David Ellis again on the guitar. Very nice. Dennis Norman again on the tenor saxophone. And again, Jimmy Chen on the drums. Very nice play. Mr. Kidwell said so much about our guest artist already. And what I can tag on to that is just a few things. One is that I remember very clearly when I first really heard John play, and it was 24 years ago, I figured out, because 24 years ago in the summer, I was in Branson, Missouri, playing Lawrence Welk show with Jay Daversa, who is John's dad, who was an amazing mentor to me, and it meant everything for me as a young guy, not only to be doing that gig on the Welk show, but also playing some keyboards in his band, and found out where John got the propensity for his technical, chromatic sort of lines. Cool stuff. But John came that summer, and I remember hearing him play, really for me, for the first time. And when we were at a little deal at Fall Creek Resort, or one of those Tuesday things, and was like, wow, this guy is going to be something. And something he is, not only as you already have heard, is an amazing trumpeter and on the EV and the uniqueness of that, but as a composer and arranger, I think he has a unique voice that in the jazz world is something that is not easy to achieve. Had we had more time to prepare, I think we would have tried to tackle some of the music from his latest big band album called Kaleidoscope, that's the music of the Beatles. And if you haven't heard that album, please check that out. It's some of the most innovative, interesting writing I think that I've heard in many, many years, and it really is something. He's doing something different with the music, and I think that people will look back and talk about him as being a major influence. But we're doing some great music of his tonight, but we didn't tackle that. We didn't have the strings and everything, but another time we're going to do that. And also another plug before I bring him out. Tomorrow night, John is going to be back here on stage with our small group, and I will be trying to fill in for Bob Minster as best I can on some of the tenor saxophone parts on his other latest album, small group album called Wobbly Dance Flower, and we're going to be doing most of the music from that album tomorrow night at 8 o'clock, so we hope that you'll come back for that. So without more stuff, please help me welcome back John Daversa to the stage. Thank you. Joe Barger, also in tenor sax. They're good, right? I wanted to share with you too, the Monterey Next Generation Jazz Festival is a big deal. It's amazing, and I went to a jazz festival that was very close to that area the weekend after these folks played and threw down at the Monterey Festival in Santa Cruz. And so a lot of the same educators and a lot of the same people are involved with the Monterey Jazz Festival, and they went to the Santa Cruz Jazz Festival. And so I wasn't at the Monterey Festival, and they were all talking about, we were at the Monterey Jazz Festival, we heard some great bands, and boy, we heard this one band from Oklahoma, you wouldn't believe how great they sounded. I said, really, from Oklahoma? Yeah, and they were such a humble group, and they went in there, and they just played so great. I said, oh, that's cool. These folks. So you spread the word in a marvelous way. So that was a tune I wrote about, it's been a while ago now, it's when my daughter was born, she's 7, and it was just a happy time. There's a lot of joy and hope and happiness in that music there, and perhaps my Oklahoma humor is a little bit in the title. It's called some happy stuff. And this is also, it's off of a record called Artful Joy, which is all about that moment that was just such a moment of joy. And the next one we're going to play is off a record called Junk Wagon, and it features the bass clarinet. And we're going to have, so Dr. Gurl told me, said, I've got this really happening baritone sax player and bass clarinet player. He really did. And I said, you have any charts? And I said, let's try a couple of these. So this is something that I wrote for a really fine bass clarinetist in Los Angeles that plays in my band named Bob Carr. And I'm so happy to share this now. This is called Most of All. Thank you. How about another hand for John Daversa? And Leon Williams. So we're going to play one more tune. Again, thank you guys. I know these are marathon concerts. How about a hand for all the other students that have played tonight? So John sent us some charts and things to consider. I listened to this one, and my first thought was, this is really hard. And then I thought, this is the one we're going to do. So when he got here, he's like, you guys are doing that? Yeah, so. You never did. You should explain the title, because I want to know the story, too. It has to be a story.
I'll think a while. Make some fun.
So there I was. I wrote the tune, I think, when I was a freshman in college. The tune itself, which was a couple of years ago. And I actually didn't have a copy of it. And somebody, I played a gig somewhere, and they walked up to me and said, Frog on a Hot Rock. And that was the title of this tune that I'd written that long ago. I hadn't thought about this tune in all of those years, in 25 years. And then I started thinking about it after, and I started to remember the melody. And I had this commission coming up. Someone asked to commission this piece. And I had 2 minutes to write it. And I was like, I'm going to try and remember that tune and write it out. And they also asked me to write something that was that had something to do with, actually there were two commissions. There was one that we played with Mr. Kidwell's band, that was the Benevolent Swamp thing, and then this one, and they wanted something that was kind of swampy. And so I thought, well, frogs come from the swamp, so that'll work. And then I started thinking about these frogs, you know, faster than a frog on a hot rock, you know, and how they move from rock to rock and from swamp to swamp and in the water, and how many different things they go through. And so that's why in this tune, it starts in one feel, and then it gets faster, and then it gets faster, and then it gets slower, and so you just kind of watch the journey of this frog. And then you have to think about the journey of this frog, because there's a truck that comes after. And then at the end, you just have to make a decision for yourself if the frog made it or not.
Thank you. Thank you.
out of Daversa. Have a safe night. Thank you, guys.